Hi everyone, and welcome to the next tutorial where I'll be teaching you how to clear your Docker cache. Now this is a very important thing to remember because there will be times when you are rebuilding your Docker image several times until you get it perfect. And what you'll notice now and then is for some reason, when you run Docker build Docker Compose build and you're trying to build your Docker image, you'll notice sometimes it seems like it's timing out or it's taking way too long to build a Docker image. Now this can happen, okay, if your Docker cache gets filled up, all right, so that can happen. And I just want to teach you how to sort of, you know, escape that problem. So the first thing I just want to explain, so let's say you're building your Docker image. So we say Docker Compose and we say build, okay. Now, if you watched my video from my previous video, you'll notice that the first time you ran this command, it took a long time. It took a couple minutes. And you'll notice now when I did it, okay, you see it only took not even 2 seconds. It was very fast. Okay, so the reason for that, okay, is because Docker can tell the changes that we've made and the changes we haven't made to our project and, for example, to our requirements.txt and so on. So basically it caches what it already has and just simply, you know, adds on what is new. Okay, so this is the reason why it's so fast, because Docker caches everything. So that is something to bear in mind. So basically when you attempt to run Docker Compose build, what can happen is your cache can become cluttered and it can take time to build your Docker image. Now this doesn't always happen, but when you are rebuilding and building Docker images 20, 30 times, okay, it can reach a point where it takes a while to build your image. Now, I'm just going to show you how you can clear your cache here. So let's just clear our console. Right. So what you can do is you can type the following command. So Docker space builder, and you want to type in space prune. So you can go ahead and enter this command here. And basically it's going to say, this will remove all dangling build cache. Are you sure you want to continue? Now, I wouldn't advise that you do this every time, okay? Only in the event when you are trying to rebuild your Docker image and you realize it's taking way too long to build, then I would advise that you clear the cache. Don't do this too often, just do it now and then when you absolutely need to. So it took me a while to figure this out. So it's just asking you, are you sure you want to continue to remove the dangling build cache? So you can say yes. So go ahead and do this, and you'll see it will remove all of the cache, and effectively if you run your Docker, if you want to build your Docker image again, okay, it's going to work like normal without that long wait. Okay, there we go. So it has cleared our cache, and we can see the reclaim space that has occurred, and we can see all of our deleted build cache objects here. So let's go ahead and clear it. So that is basically how you would clear your Docker cache. Very important. So be aware of that command. So Docker builder prune. Very important command to remember. Now, if we were to go ahead and rebuild our Docker image, so Docker compose build. Okay. All right, let's go ahead and run it. Okay, you will now notice that we are all good to go and everything is cleaned up and ready for us. Okay. So just be wary of that command, okay? It is used to clear our Docker cache, okay? So basically what would use case for that would happen was your Docker compose build function will take forever to run. And basically by clearing the cache, okay, it's going to run your Docker images much faster since your cache is cleared. All right, so that's that. Just a short example here of what I was showing you. And that's it, guys. So I hope this helped you to clearing your Docker cache. So remember that, clear your cache whenever you see you're having issues with building your Docker image. So a useful command, very helpful. And yeah, that's it, guys. So I hope that helped, and thank you so much.